of us are leaving our reach. Thank you, Mr. President. But the Honorable President says, by the indulgence of the Senate and the leave of the President of the Senate, a senator may make a personal explanation, although there be no question before the Senate, but no controversial matter may be introduced forward, nor may the debate arise from the explanation. The terms of the proposed statement shall be submitted in detail to the President of the Senate when he leaves to make his thoughts. Mr. President, the three colleagues, like I said, once again, my name is Rezaya, I represent Imo East. Mr. President, you are aware that a week ago, precisely last Thursday, a constituent of mine by the name Mrs. Bridges was murdered in Kano. And that one is from my immediate constituency, not even my surrounding district. And when I traveled home last week, Mr. President, for the weekend, my house was besieged by my constituents who feel so concerned and worried about this gruesome murder. And Mr. President, this is just one of these murders. And last November in 1995, precisely, one of my constituents too, Gideon Akaloka, was killed this way. Mr. President, we are asking that this is a woman that has lived in Kano for 40 years, almost all her life. And she's 75 years old, Mr. President. And I think that this is a very sorry situation. And I think that this city should rather condemn this kind of act. It has continued to go every day. Mr. President, at this time, what we should be thinking and doing is that which will unite us as a country and not that which will continue to divide us. I feel so pain. The people of my constituency are so pain. And even though, Mr. President, I want to appreciate the governor of Kano State and of course the commissioner of police who have taken a step to make some arrests. But I think that it should go beyond that, Mr. President. We don't want a situation where somebody is going to dead in them. After a period of time, we hear about that matter. This is one matter, Mr. President, because the worst thing that could happen to a man is to kill your wife right before your face, Mr. President. This is very pathetic. And I think that this incident should arise and condemn this kind of act. We are one Nigeria. We all believe in one Nigeria. We want to live together. We want to respect, you know, our religious inclinations in this country. I believe that this country was united. I have always said, Mr. President, that in one statement here today, the Igbos are the most people who are more liberalized people because we believe in one Nigeria. We live in every part of this country. And I feel that the way we are being treated. I think this Senate should rise, Mr. President, and ask the police to ensure that this matter is being brought to book. Thank you very much, Mr. President.
All right, thank you so much, sister of your constituency, the entire state, and indeed to the entire Nigerians, because every show matters for us as Nigerians. The rate of killing Nigeria is becoming very embarrassing. So we must do everything as leaders to protect lives and properties of the citizens of this country. Every life matters to us, and we cannot continue on the path of diminishing human life in Nigeria. So I think it is a responsibility of the security agencies to ensure that every Nigerian is protected wherever he lives, and to ensure that it doesn't happen, every effort must be made to official those responsible, and then so that they will face the wrath of the law. So once we accept our condolences, we believe that this might be the last of this kind of incidents anywhere in Nigeria. Thank you.